Yes, and can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. But I cannot see you.
Yeah, fine. But now?
No, not yet. No, actually, we are changing our Wi-Fi. So today I might have to, you know, I might have the most problem today itself.
Even I can't see you. You have closed your video or?
Hello. Are you talking?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. No. I'm not switched it off. I have kept it on, but I guess maybe it's trying to save the Wi-Fi and that is why it's switched off.
Okay.
Yesterday also, it kind of gave me the message later on when the meeting ended that it was trying to save and all of that. So.
Okay. We'll start with the concepts for exercise, the last exercise that is 3.5. What all concepts we require, we'll study that. Okay, so under that, the first concept that you need to know is inscribed angle. Understand first what is the meaning of inscribed angle and how an inscribed angle looks like.
Yes.
Okay. Can you see the screen?
Yeah. Okay. But it's blank.
Now?
But it's blank.
Now, what you can see right now? Inscribe, can you see inscribe?
Now also it's blank. Now, yeah, it's blank. Only white I can see. Yeah, now the circle. Yeah.
There is a lag. There is a lag then, I think. I hope you understand in spite of the lag being there.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'll just...
Yeah, now there is not a lag. Now I can see you put it and now you removed it and now you again put one
back. Okay, fine.
Third and second.
We'll continue. Now, in an angle which has its vertex, okay, an angle, listen carefully, an angle that has its vertex. Vertex means corner point. On the circle is called an inscribed angle. Okay? An angle whose has its vertex on the circle is called an inscribed angle. In this figure, if you see, angle DCB. So angle DCB means this one here, this angle here, angle DCB, this angle is inscribed inside the arc DCB. Okay, that means it is drawn inside the arc DCB. Okay, so an angle that is angle DCB is drawn, or in other words, inscribed inside the arc DCB. So angle DCB is called an inscribed angle and it intercepts the arc DB. Okay, it intercepts the arc DB. This arc DB is the arc which it intercepts. So intercept means it is drawn above it. Okay. So that arc, that angle formed in such a way is called an inscribed angle. So this is the angle inscribed and the arc exactly in front of that angle is called as the intercepted arc. Okay. And the arc in which it is drawn, that arc is called an inscribed angle arc. Is this terms clear? What is an inscribed angle? What is an inscribed arc? An intercepted arc. Okay. So now since you know inscribed angle, since you have learned what is inscribed angle, let's move on to, okay, these are just the terms, okay, angle DCB, that is this angle here, is inscribed angle, and DB, that is the arc in front of the inscribed angle, is called as intercepted arc.
Intercepted arc.
Two terms to remember. Okay, now next we have the inscribed.
What if the inscribed angle is 90 degrees?
If the inscribed angle is 90, it can be 90 degrees. So that means it will be formed in the semicircle.
Okay.
If the inscribed angle is 90 degrees, means that arc above it is a semicircle, semicircular arc. Okay, so now we have a theorem. Inscribed angle theorem. This theorem is lengthy. Has your school done the proof of this theorem?
Yes.
Inscribed angle theorem, understand the statement first. So this is very easy to, the result is very easy. The proof is lengthy, but so the measure of an inscribed angle is half of the measure of the arc intercepted by it. The measure of an inscribed angle is half of the measure of the arc intercepted by it. Carefully understand the meaning of this. This theorem says that if you see this angle here, angle BAC is the inscribed angle, and arc BC, okay, or we'll call this arc BDC, okay, arc BDC, okay, so it's the intercepted arc, this is the intercepted arc, this is the inscribed angle. So this theorem says that the inscribed angle is half of the arc it intercepts. The measure of the inscribed angle is half of the arc that it intercepts. So for example, if the arc is 60 degree, okay, if the measure of the arc is 60 degree, then the measure of this inscribed angle will be half of 60. That is 30 degree. If the arc measures is 70 degree, then the measure of the inscribed angle is half of the arc, that is 35 degree, and so on. Have you understood what this theorem tells you, what result it gives you? It just says measure of the inscribed angle is half of the arc that it intersects. Yes, have you understood?
Yes.
This other way around also, it is true. What do I mean by other way around? If the measure of the inscribed angle is 20 degree, then what will be the measure of the intercepted arc? We are saying inscribed angle is half of this. Now, inscribed angle is 20. So what will be arc? Measure of the arc, it measure of the intercepted arc. Yes. Whatever is here, inscribed angle is half of this. So this is 20. So what should be this measure of this arc?
Yeah.
How much? What did you say?
Hello.
Yes.
Yeah, what are you saying?
I said, if the measure of the inscribed angle is 20, then what will be the measure of the intercepted arc? 20
each.
Huh? 20? How 20? What we just now studied.
Because the entire thing is 20. This, the entire thing is... Yeah. If the entire thing is 20, then it'll be 20.
No. No. What this theorem says, measure of the inscribed angle is half of the measure of the intercepted arc. Okay, half of this.
Oh, so if 10 degrees.
This is half of this. Inscribed angle is half of this. So I'm saying now inscribed angle is 20. So what will be the arc then? Measure of the arc.
10.
No, you didn't get it still. Inscribed angle is half of the intercepted arc. This is inscribed angle here. This is the inscribed angle, and this is the intercepted arc. Okay, this is the intercepted arc. Inscribed angle is half of intercepted arc. Okay, inscribed angle is half of intercepted arc. So if the intercepted arc is 30 degree, suppose, or suppose if the intercepted arc is 60 degree, half of 60, 30. That means this is 30. This you understood?
Yes. So the one in front also will be 30.
No, that is... Which will be 30, you're saying?
BDE will also be 30 degrees.
Arc or angle?
Yes.
Arc. Okay, but we are not concerned about BDE. Don't look at that. Note one thing, there is difference between intercepted inscribed angle and central angle. Both are different. B, D, E. And this I'll call it B, A. So here now, this is inscribed angle. That means angle B, B, E is inscribed angle, and this is intercepted arc. This is intercepted arc. That means arc B, A, E is intercepted arc. This theorem says inscribed angle is half of the intercepted arc. That means whatever is here will be half of this. Okay, so if
whatever is here is will be the half of this. So if that is 70, then this will be 35.
Yes, if this is 70, this will be 35.
That is 20. So that is 20 means yes. This is 40.
Yes.
BAE is 40.
Yes, that is what I was expecting. Yes, correct. 40. Okay. So it's here. Fine, you got it. Now then we can start with the proof, because that sums will definite those every type of sums, intercepted, finding the inscribed angle, finding a measure of the arc can definitely come for MCQ. One mark. Okay. So given, let's start with what is given. In a circle with center O, BAC is the inscribed angle. That means this BAC is the inscribed angle, and it is inscribed inside the arc BAC, and it is intercepted by this arc BDC. Okay, we are using three letter notation for this intercepted arc BDC. Okay, so this is given to us. What we have to prove? We have to prove inscribed angle BAC is half of the arc, measure arc BDC. This is what we have to prove. the result. Is this clear up to here?
Yes.
So we can start with the proof. Now, in triangle AOC, that is this triangle that we have formed here. Okay, before that, you have to do a construction. Okay, you have to do a construction. You draw take E to be the midpoint of arc BC, and you just draw a ray AE, and then you join C with the center of the circle. Okay, this and this is the two construction which you have to do. Okay, now you see in triangle AOC. Okay, look inside the triangle AOC. In triangle AOC, first thing, segment OA and or side OA and side OC will be congruent to each other. And the reason for that is they are the radius of the same circle. Then, if these two sides are equal, if these two sides are equal, their opposite angles will also be equal to each other. Okay, or you can say otherwise this becomes an isosceles triangle, and in an isosceles triangle, opposite sides are equal to each other. Opposite angles are equal to each other. So angle OAC, that is this one, and angle OCA, that is this angle, both will be equal to each other. Are these first two statements clear? Yes.
Yeah.
Now, what we'll do is we'll just take consider the measure of these angles to be x. So, angle OAC equal to angle OCA is equal to x, and call it as equation number one. Now, here you have to remember the exterior angle theorem. What does the exterior angle theorem say? Exterior angle theorem says that the measure of the exterior angle is equal to the sum of the measure of its two interior angles. So if you see angle EOC, that is this one, this is exterior. Okay, so the exterior angle is equal to sum of the interior angle. Do you remember this theorem? Exterior angle theorem.
Yes.
So the exterior angle EOC is equal to angle OAC, that is this, plus angle OCA, that is this one. Okay. But what we have assumed? We have assumed angle OAC is X and OCA is also X. So substitute this here. X plus X is equal to 2X. So here we can say angle EOC is equal to 2X degree. That is, this is 2X. Okay. Now, if angle EOC is 2X, note one thing. Angle EOC is formed at the center of the circle. So angle EOC, that is this angle here, is the central angle. Okay, angle EOC is a central angle because it is formed at the center of the circle. So one property you know, that central angle and the arc in front of the central angle have the same measure. So that means measure of this arc EC will be same as measure of angle EOC. Measure of angle EOC is 2x. So measure of the arc EC will also be 2x degrees. So measure of arc EC, 2x. Did you understand the theorem?
Yes.
Okay. We'll move forward. So this is 2x. Arc EC 2x degree. This one, 2x.
Oh, exterior angles aren't linear pairs?
Exterior and linear pairs with what?
Linear pairs with each other like that. So x plus x equals to 180.
No, if it is, no. If it is straight line, no, then only it will be linear pair. Otherwise, no.
Okay.
So now if you see, this is our equation 1 and this is your equation 2. So from equation 1 and 2, you can say that angle OCA is x and arc EC is 2x. So from here we can say that angle OAC, that is this one, angle OAC is half of measure arc EC, because measure arc EC is 2x. Measure of angle OAC is x. Do you understand this equation number 3?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. Just note one thing. These two are the same. Okay. They are the same thing. It's just that OAC or EAC. Okay. It means the same. The angle is the same. OAC or EAC. Basically, we are talking about this angle here. Okay. So angle OAC or EAC is half of arc EC. Now, this we worked on the right side, that is on this side we worked. Same thing you can do on the left hand side, that is on this side. You will have to join BO and so on, and same thing. So that's why we directly say, similarly by drawing segment OB, you can prove that angle EAB is half of arc BE. That you call it as equation number 4. Have you understood this?
Yes.
Okay. Now,
I have to write this.
Wait, we are not done yet. Equation 3 and equation 4. Now, from equation 3 and 4, you have to add it. Okay, you have to add equation 3 and equation 4. So, right hand side, add with right hand side. So, angle EAC, that is this one, and plus angle EAB, that is this one, is equal to half of measure arc EC, that is this one, plus half of measure arc BE, that is this one. So we are just adding equation number 3 and equation number 4. Now, you look at angle EAC plus EAB. EAC is this one. EAB is this one. So when you add both of them, you get this entire angle. So that you can name it as angle BAC, this entire one. Okay, angle BAC. And from your right hand side, you just take a half common outside. So you'll have measure arc EC plus measure arc BE. Now, if you look at this, measure arc EC plus BE is nothing but this entire arc from here, which you can name it as BDE. Okay, so measure arc B or BEC, either one you can name, BEC or BDC. So you can finally say that measure angle BAC, which is the inscribed angle, is half of measure arc BDC, which we had to prove. So this is the final statement which we had to prove. Did you understand the theorem? Yes?
Yes.
So I want you to write it down.
Yeah, just give me 1 minute. I have to go. I'll come back and then I'll write.
Yeah.
Or I'll write and then I'll go.
Yeah. Just tell me when to go to the next slide.
Yeah, can you move on to the next slide? Yeah, done right now.
Okay. Any doubts in this theorem? Yes. Any doubts in this theorem? You there?
Hello.
Yes. Hello. Can you hear me? Yes, can you hear me now? Unmute yourself.
Yes.
So is the theorem clear? Any doubts in the theorem?
No, I have to write this.
No, first understand it and then I'll tell you when to write. Okay. So in this, you have to consider three cases regarding the position of the center of the circle and the inscribed angle. Okay, so there are three positions of the center and the position of the inscribed angle. So first, the center of the circle. If the center of the circle lies on one of the arms of the angles, second is in the interior and third is in the exterior. I'll show you with the diagrams.
Hello.
Yes. 1 minute. Actually, my PPT got off. Can you hear me, Nabal?
Yes.
Yes, yes. But just wait for a moment. Just give me a moment. Okay, so now in the previous case, if you see, in this case, the center of the circle lies between the inscribed angle. So here, if you see the center, it lies between the inscribed angle, that is inside. Now, in this second case, is when the center of the circle lies in the exterior of the inscribed angle. So if you see in this particular diagram, the center of the circle is outside the inscribed angle. So your BAC is the inscribed angle. BAC, this one is the inscribed angle and the center is outside. So when the center is outside this inscribed angle, the proof changes a little bit. So angle BAC is, the result remains the same, only the proof changes. So BAC, that is this angle here, BAC will be BAE, that is this entire angle, minus CAE. Okay, BAE will be BAC will be BAE minus CAE. Is this clear?
Yes.
So by similar results, we can say
instead of doing all of that, why can't we just say that BAE is equal to BAC plus CAE instead of doing minus?
Yes, yes. Yes.
Can this we do addition, because it will be easier? No?
Yes, you can. But from that step only, we get this. Rearranging that only, you will get this.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
So by the previous results, you can say that measure angle BAE, okay, that is this entire thing, is half of the arc in front of it, because it's an inscribed angle. So it is half of BCE. Similarly, you can say that CAE, that is this angle, inscribed angle, is half of arc CE. Okay, so this is half of arc BCE. And this is
just 1 minute, I have to open the door. Yeah, I'm so sorry. Yeah, done.
Okay. So if you see now, we have half of arc BCE minus half of arc CE. Take half common outside, and inside you'll get arc BCE minus arc CE. So arc BCE is this entire thing, minus arc CE is this one. Okay, so this entire thing minus this is arc BC. So that's how you replace it with arc BC. The result is remaining the same. That is, inscribed angle is half of the intercepted arc. Just that in this case, the center of the circle is outside the circle, outside the inscribed angle. The center of the circle is outside the inscribed angle. That's it here. Otherwise, the result is the same. Is it clear?
Yes.
Write it down. Give the heading. For here, you give the heading center of the circle. Lies in the exterior of the inscribed angle.
Yeah.